Let's go straight to Jordan Fabris now, who is further west on the border at Gundawindi. Jordan, dozens of drivers already being turned around there.
Yeah, good evening, Andrew. That's right. In 24 hours, around 30 motorists have been turned away at the checkpoint here at Gundawindi. As you can see, it is one of the busiest outside of southeast Queensland. And on top of those 30, we've had 16 people in 24 hours put into quarantine. And that includes two grey nomads who lied on their border declaration passes here at the checkpoint to get into Queensland. They couldn't enjoy it for very long, though. Police did catch up with them yesterday, and they are now in quarantine and will face court at a later date. Melissa, this is a major freight route into Queensland, and police have told me it's only going to get busier when the border slams shut.
I'm sure it will, Jordan. Thank you. Well, we are effectively becoming Fortress Queensland, with blockades designed to hold back a growing wave of illegal border hoppers. Authorities declaring the danger they pose to us all is simply too great.
The Premier's patience finally tipping over the edge, pushed by a band of selfish breaches who've crossed our state's line too many times.
The breaches will now stop.
Since the border reopened on July 10, 36 people have been caught lying on border passes. The fear, any one of them could spark more outbreaks. It's a gamble Queensland will no longer take.
Whilst those numbers are small, the risk is too high.
The catalogue of deception has taken many forms.
One of you might have it right now.
Six Victorians in a van, a New South Wales resident in a car boot.
Why are you trying to sneak across, mate?
One Rockhampton doctor duped his way out of virus-riddled Melbourne, where two infected women and a friend partied before skirting checkpoints, igniting a full-blown emergency in Logan, a feat just on Sunday, repeated by three men.
Those three men who remain under police guard in hotel quarantine have now tested negative for the virus. They will be tested again, though, before they're allowed back to their homes in Logan.
Today, two more people found in Nanango joined the list, along with the man who drove out of hotspot Sydney to Canberra just to fly onto Cairns.
And that person has expressed they were frustrated with the restrictions, didn't like them and wanted to go to work. So a quite selfish approach.
Some have been fined, others ordered off to court. Either way, the wrong way into Queensland is slammed shut. Rob Morrison, Nine News.